Hello guys, this is Vijay from Dino Code Academy. So in this video, we are going to add a new button inside this result activity. A new button means we are going to place another button inside this layout so that on click of that particular button, a user can play the next level quiz which user have unlocked while playing the level 1 or level 2. So what I mean, if the user has unlocked the level 1, so we want to allow the user while click on the next button. So user can play the level 2, means user will again redirect to this particular screen, which is on level screen of the history category. And if the user inside the computer category, then on click of that particular play next level button, user can actually come to this particular screen, which is a computer screen activity of the level, which is a computer level screen activity. So from there, user can select its computer level screen quiz. Okay, so that is the functionality we want to do. Also guys, one more important thing. This all the categories is now up to you because it's a copy paste work and there is a copy paste. There is no such a new thing to learn inside the copy paste because you just only need to do what? You need to create a, you need to copy and paste this simple history level activity into English level activity. And then inside that you need to change these particular variable values. All of these variables you need to change it. And then also you need to change the English and also you need to change the corresponding constant files which we have specified inside the constant.java. So use those constant.java. Right now you can see these are highlighted as gray because it is never used. Okay. So I hope you can implement all of these categories by yourself. If you are not able to do that, then definitely you can comment down below the video or you can also message me directly on my Instagram by following me on Instagram. I will definitely create a video for you guys. Now let's get start implementing the next button functionality inside this result activity screen. So first we need to place a new button. So I'm going to go to the design tab or you can just simply copy this button. So I'm going to copy this button here and I'm going to paste it. And now I'm going to remove the ID of this button. Just remove the ID. Then you can see it's actually the button and it's having a main menu. So we need to just change the text to like next level. I can see it as next level. Also, you can see the height of this button. So we need to change the height to wrap content. So the height is wrap content. I think we are using a layout weight property. So we need to specify here layout 3. Now you can see everything is working fine. So you can see there is so much spacing is there. Just removing the margin start for this one. Now they are looking good because the spaces are aligned properly. And now I'm going to specify an on click event inside this particular one, which is a newly added button on click. And I'm going to say data to send to level, send to level again. So I'm going to create this callback inside the result activity. Now this actually callback created inside the result activity. Now with the help of this particular category again value, we are going to compare and then start a corresponding activity. We are going to compare the value and then start a corresponding activity. So specify category value dot equals. If it's the category of the computers, if it is a category of the computer, then we need to do what? We just need to start the activity, which is a computer category level activity screen. So it's the intent computer is equal to new then intent, and here we need to specify the result, which is a result activity dot class. So not class, we need to specify this and comma, and then we need to start here a computer level activity dot class. Now we don't need to pass the data with the use of put extra method because we already starting a separate activities, so there is no point of any data passing. Okay, and also we need to compare the another category which is for the history. So else if, and then I'm going to copy this code from here, copy that and paste it here. And if it is a category of the history, then we need to start the quiz again. So I'm going to copy it again from here and paste it here. And instead of that, I'm going to change it into history. Copy that and paste it here. Then we need to start here from history level activity dot class. Okay. So now the code is completed. When we click on that particular button, this callback will be executed, which is this callback. Where is our result? This callback will be executed. Alright. So now it's time to run the application to see whether this is actually working or not. Now you can see our application is now running. If I click on the play and if I select on history, if I just select simply level 1, now you can see the correct answer for this one is no. Correct. And is for this one is actually the correct one is fourth one. For this one, second one is correct. And for this one, the fourth one is correct. Now we are inside the result activity. So if I click on play next, means this next level button. Then you can see we are now inside the history level activity in which we have unlocked two levels. That is 1, 2, and then the level 3 is actually locked. Now again, going back. Now at this point of time, I'm going to select the computer. And if you can see, I'm just going to select the level 3. And from there, if I select personal computer. And for this one, I select the phone is the correct answer. Again, this one is correct. Quiz is finished. And now you can see, we are now inside the result activity. If I click on this next level. Then you can see we are now inside the computer level screen activity. So our next play button functionality working well. So guys, that marks the completion of this whole series. The only thing is left, you need to implement this rest of the quiz categories, that is English, Math and Graphics. And if you are entering more than 10 categories, then guys, you need to do this approach manually. And at the beginning, I already told you, that is the reason, because we are actually using an offline database, which is SQLite. So that is why this is the whole thing we need to type manually. If you are using an online database like a Firestore, which is a recommended one for this type of quiz, then the process will become more easy to handle because the Firestore has a lot of advantage using it, because it has some functions which is specifically meant for nesting of the data. Means nesting of the data means nesting of the nodes, because it actually stores data in a form of bucket. So that is why the Firestore is a recommended way for building these kinds of quiz application. That has a category, and then on that category we have the levels. So guys, if you enjoy this series, then definitely share this video to your friends and also give at least 30 likes, which will be more motivating for me to create new and awesome videos for you. And definitely in future I will create a quiz application by using a Firestore, and I will create that particular quiz application and show you how easy it is to actually create the application by using Firestore, and that complexity will be managed easily. So I'm going to create that particular quiz if I get a good response in that particular series, because it will take a lot of effort to create videos like this one. Right now you can see how much code I need to type just to implement that particular requested feature, because there are so many subscribers ask me to implement this particular feature. So I receive the feedback, and definitely if you want to give more suggestions, then I will definitely respond to your query. And some of the subscribers ask me to add another functionality, that is playing the sound inside the quiz infinitely in the background, which is a very difficult task, because right now we are inside the Android P emulator. There is so much restriction while playing the audio in the background, but I am going to provide you a way how you can play the background music infinitely in the background while playing the quiz in the upcoming videos. So that's it for this video guys. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, then share it with your friend. And if you are new to my channel, then definitely subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon so that you get notification when I upload a new video. So thank you for watching guys. See you in the next videos.